Hey guys, it's Maymay and old Shannon's here today.
Hey y'all.
Instead of old Vinny. Old Vinny's taking a day. He had a little bit of a bad night of sleep last night and it kind of drug on into the morning and I said, just take a break. So he's working from home. He's getting stamp club done, but I told him, just take a break. Sometimes we need one and today he's taking one. Doesn't even have to do with hunting. How about that? So I thought before we got started, I wanted to tell you something because right before we came on the live show, I got an email with a newsletter from Cricut saying that they have put today their bundles are on sale. I want to say it's through the 9th, through February 9th. Their machine bundles are on sale and they've got supplies at 40% off. So Shannon put the link in the chat for you guys and it's also in the description of this video. The bundle that I bought for $214 is on sale today for $199. And I think it's through the 9th. And when you purchase, make sure you use my code because it won't give you 10% off of everything, but you can also get free shipping if you spend over $50. And like I bought before we went live, I went, what? I went and bought some supplies at 40% off and used my code also. So just wanted to tell you that because I didn't realize they were having a sale and that's super cool. And this is the machine I'm talking about. For those of you who've been watching my videos, this is the Joy machine. And like I said, I paid $214 for my bundle and they've got it for $199. So if you need that or any supplies or even not just for your Joy machine, other supplies for other things, I want to make sure I tell you because that's a good deal. So here's what we're doing today. We are doing minute cards. That's what I'm going to call them. I had somebody, who was it? We're talking about, in my mini album I did recently, a commenter said that they struggle with stickers, like placement of stickers and stuff like that. So I thought I'd show you this because I think it's fun. And I'm going to take this off. I think it's fun. So I thought we'd make a girl card and a boy card together. So I have no idea what I'm going to do. I just got this stuff out. Shannon and I were walking around and I'm like, oh, this is a good idea. Since we had somebody say that they struggle with cards, or not cards, but using stickers, I thought we would try this, right? We would see where it goes. So this is I just didn't even tell you what this is. This is available in our store. This is a Card Maker's Choice 100-pound heavyweight craft cardstock as well as the envelopes. These envelopes are beautiful. The envelopes you get in here are absolutely gorgeous. So we're going to use card bases. And they happen to work really well with the sticker books because so usually, a lot of times, your stickers will have like a white border like some of these do. But look, these even have craft colored borders. So I think it'll be real cute with the craft card bases. We don't have a whole lot of those right now. We just ordered another set of these in. But I just love this 100-pound card. They're pre-scored and ready to go. So since they're pre-scored, I'm just going to fold this over. And as always, line your card up first. And then let your bone folder kind of tell the card where to fold. And you'll get a much better square that way. So there's our card. And these can go either orientation. Now, the one thing I did, which I think is handy, is I have this sticker book, right? I went and found a 6x6 pad that coordinated because I do want to do a background. Now, could I stick stickers directly to this? Yes, that's not a problem. But I kind of think I'd get a cuter card or get more interest in the card if I do some sort of background to it. So I haven't even looked at stickers. I don't know what I'm going to be using in here. So why don't we start there and it'll kind of guide where we're going. So every page, well, not every page. I think you get two sheets of 16. Is it two sheets? I think there's two sheets of each one.
I know there's at least two because I saw the tree twice.
The first thing I just went, that's the cutest thing
it
ever.
Is.
I think I'm going to use it. I don't know what we're going to do with it. So look, here's what I like to do. I'm going to pull out one piece. Okay, I'm just going to sit it to my work surface. I'm not going to touch it down. If I touch it down, it'll stick, right? And then I'm just going to look through and see what goes with that tree. So this is kind of like a little tree house. Let's Play is cute. It's game night. Let's see. Welcome to our fort. How cute is that? Like for a home, like maybe we've moved or something. Discovery, you're super cool. Outdoors, let's go. Let's just keep looking. There's all kinds of stuff in here. Life is one great adventure with you. That's cute.
Shirt.
Play all day. That is all boy. Making memories that last a lifetime. That's cute. Boys rule. Sometimes being a brother is better than being a superhero. That's so cute. Ooh, happy birthday. Champ is cute.
That's cute.
You can't be sad. When in doubt, ride it out. Oh, it's talking about bikes. I don't know. These bikes are real cute too. This is the part that always takes you longest. Pick it out. You got to decide. All right, so let's go back. Here comes trouble. So cute. Have fun is cute. Fill your pocket with adventures. Every dog needs a boy. Gone fishing, play, discover. Boys are the best. I kind of like this have fun. I think that'll be cute. And then I like these banners, but I think, yeah, here's this one with all these words. So let's do remember when is cute. Boys will make it happen. Once upon a time, courage is too cool. Laugh out loud, play hard. Play hard is so cute. Let's do, I'm going to get out this happy birthday sticker. Don't know how I'm going to use it, but I like that as a sentiment. Happy birthday, dude. That's cute, right?
That is cute.
Oh, handsome dude. Happy birthday, handsome dude.
Well, you can say this for Vinny for his birthday.
And then look at all these little borders. So let's see if I want to use one of these. I kind of like this stripey one. I think that one's cute. So let's put that one out. And maybe even this red one. Okay, so it looks like my background is going to be green heavy. So I don't want to use green in my background. So maybe I want to use maybe yellow, like sunshine. Let's just look. The orange is cute. The red is cute because of the blue to be like the sky.
Yeah.
I don't know. That yellow's cute, isn't it? Let's do yellow. It'll be bright and cheery. All right. So the cool thing is, this is how things go fast with these cards, okay? You're able to, because you know the size of your card bases, I can get my mat easy. I know my card is 4 1/4, so I'm going to cut a mat that is 4 by 5 1/4. So I know that will be just right. You can make, these will go so fast. Oh, I almost spilled my drink. Look at that yellow with that craft. We just discovered today, we were making a wreath, and the yellow with the burlap is really pretty
very
together.
Cute.
I've never thought to put those two colors together, but it's really pretty. I'm gonna squish that down again so it'll lay flat. That's cute. All right, so once you have these on your work surface, if you're worried about them sticking or whatever, I just use my tweezers to help me pick them up. Look at that little thing. All right, I'm gonna stick that on my hand and I'm gonna go to my borders because I kind of want them. Do I want them to go all the way across? That might be cute too, to go all the way across my whole card. So like glue this down and then maybe have my border, yeah, go all the way. Okay, let's do that. So I'm gonna put my little sticker aside and come back to it. Let's glue this guy down. By the way, this is not a card in a minute. It's minute cards. So it takes minutes to do it.
Minutes.
Oh, my glue is really stuck on there. Okay, here we go. Come on, glue.
Work.
The problem with my glue is it doesn't get used as much as it used to. You know, like I haven't been in here since Saturday.
Well, we've been in here, but we've been wreathing.
We've been wreathing,
not gluing.
Let's open this dude up. There we go. I usually come in and make sure it's open because I don't come in here all the time anymore. I'm not gluing every day like I used to be. All right, so there's that. Ah! Caught it. Good job. All right, so I'm going to glue this directly down. So that's going to do most of my background work. And think about this. You totally could use a border punch or your corner punches or something to even dress that up even more if you wanted to. All right, I'm going to go back to this sticker, which is the border sticker. I want it to act like it's the ground. You know, I want to pretend like that's where my ground is. So I'm going to put it here. And I'm using my cutting mat to help me get that nice and straight. And now I can slice that. Oh, we put the big scissors over there. I'll use these. I'll put my favorite scissors are over there in the wreath area. All right, move this one out of my way. Actually, I'm going to put this back on my sticker sheet because this is totally usable again, like no issue. Find it. There we go. Now, I'm going to tell you something. These sticker books that Echo Park is doing right now, you will probably not use them all up for a very long time. Like, there's a lot in there. A lot. Now, I think I'm going to put this one above that one. Let me turn this around. Put this one above that one and put a little space between them. So I get even more interest on the card. You know, some of the yellow shows through. So it's even more of a of movement. Same thing, put this one back in the book. I'll do it later so y'all don't have to watch me do that. Okay, so now I think I'm gonna pop up my little tree house.
Pam says she bought your marker holders.
You love them? They're fantastic. I know you do. I know you do. I'm being pretty confident about that. We love them.
Yes. They're handy dandy.
All right. So on the back of this, I'm going to add foam because I want this to pop up a little bit. And you don't have to powder it. You can powder these if you want to get all the sticky to not still be there. But I just don't really do that anymore. I just pile up the foam tape and then it's fine. I got that one hanging off a little bit. Let's put him somewhere else and cut a smaller piece for that spot. There we go. Shannon, put my sticker back. That's the kind of friends you want. Y'all need to find friends that don't craft, but they like to watch, and they'll clean up behind you.
That's craft.
Yeah, but sometimes I'll go, do you want to do this? Nah, I'll just watch you.
I'm good.
Especially cricket stuff. The other day I said, do you want to do this? No, I'm good. Let me watch.
Well, I don't know what I'm doing on the cricket yet.
Oh, there's nothing to it. I'm going to have her doing videos for y'all soon.
The joy is easier than figuring out, like, the big guy.
You mean the software?
Yeah, the software for the joy is, like...
The app.
You can't mess it up. I mean, you cannot mess it up.
You can't mess up the other either. You just got to get confident.
It's easier than Facebook. I mean, it really is. Because it tells you, click this, do this.
Yeah, it does.
Are you putting this in there?
Yeah.
Do this.
All right, so this guy's going to live over here on my... I may even put him down... I think I'm gonna put him down kind of low on top of that little ground. Like so. Look how cute.
Oh, that's precious.
It's really cute.
The little stripe almost looks like that playground stuff they put down for kids that's soft.
Yeah, play stuff. Yeah.
That foamy.
Then here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna do like happy. And then happy birthday, handsome. I'm gonna stagger these. Don't want to stagger it there or here. Handsome. And then dude. Now, here's the thing. What I would do, because my habit is I like to make cards that are blank on the inside and then put them away. So I have them for later. So you can. But I would go into my stamp stash and stamp a sentiment in here. You have plenty of birthday sentiments.
Yeah.
If you're in the club, especially. And you can stamp inside of here. And then you can do all kinds of stuff to this. If you didn't feel like it was enough, you could take your... maybe your black pen if you wanted to, because I think the black will show it really good. And you might just dot, dot, dash.
Dot, dot, dash.
And you might do the whole thing, or you might just do the corners. I've done that before, where I just do parts of it. But, I mean, how quick is that card? And it's super cute and super easy. And the best part is, so if you have grandkids and you're looking for something to do, my niece Lydia loves stickers. She makes cards with stickers so well, like all the time. And I know these little books and stuff would be something she'd like. And imagine sitting down with your grandkids and letting them make some cards. And then you send them out. And the cool thing, what you need to do is somewhere on that card say, this card was made for you by. So when it arrives, the person knows, maybe a grandkid or a niece or nephew or something like that made it for them. This probably didn't need dot, dot, dashes, but I'm doing it. Also, imagine this. It's still quick and easy if you ink around the edge, if you do some distress ink.
Favorite person ever.
Those are so cute, aren't they?
You're the best son in the world.
Aw, that's cute.
I need this for Noah.
Well, just think you could use it for lots of occasions too, not just birthday. When we can have play dates again, how cute would it be to use that to make play date invitations?
You need to make Ford a card because they have a game board sticker in here.
And he just made his own game.
Have a game board.
I do need to do that. So look, there it is. Super quick and easy with no effort. That's just so cute and easy. Let's do a girl one. How long was that? 15 minutes and I talked for the first 5. Ain't that awesome?
Cuteness.
I think it is. All right, let's go to this one. And let's look for stickers. Let's start the same way. I like the dots and dashes too. Somebody says I think it really finishes a card. Love the size of that unicorn. I like something big like that to be a focal point. So let's just look through the whole thing first. Look at all these sentiments. So cute. I have to read. You color my world. She leaves a little sparkle wherever she goes. This is how I roll. The best things in life are sweet like you. This little girl holding her doll is cute. The bunny is cute. Look at the little houses.
Okay, so make a cute girly card, I can give it to Lucy because her birthday is tomorrow.
Oh, perfect. Oh, I love that. Okay, so let's decide. So let me keep looking for a second.
She turns five.
Let me find the, let me find here. Happy birthday right there. Oh, little girl, big attitude.
That's so her.
Happy birthday. Beautiful. They're the same color. Let's find a different one. Darling. Happy birthday. You say darling.
I say darling.
So happy birthday, darling. And let me see what else we could, if we might could add something to it.
Those are the cutest stickers.
Darling, I love you. Happy birthday, darling. And then I love you on the inside. Okay, so there's that. Does she have a favorite thing?
Well, she's having like a rainbow unicorn birthday. Yeah.
Okay, so we're going to do rainbows and unicorns.
Unicorns.
I'm going to take this unicorn out. Put it right here.
It's like I planned this or something.
I don't know about the, I might, let's see. Y'all, I'm sorry about my phone. We're having, I'm sorry about my camera right here. It will come back. We're having blips in our internet. I've noticed it in a couple places today. So that's what's doing that. That's cute. All right, let's see what we can do. I bet we have a pretty pinkish color. Here's a pink. Let's see if we want to use that. She's a pink girl, isn't she?
She is. She's very the girliest pink girl.
All right, so let's, I like the pink. Let's do that. Let's go ahead and do our background. And I'll even use, since I'll just even use some like punches and stuff to show y'all what I was talking about. So I'm going to do this, cut down to 4 by 5 1/4. And then I think I will use my scallop punch, my stub and scallop, and scallop the edges of this. That'll be cute for a little girl. Look, it's so cute. I need to empty this guy. When I punch little pieces attached to it, like, help us, get us out of here.
Take me away.
That's cute. See how that quickly, like, dresses it up? And then, let's decide. I might want to put something, I might want to do, like, ground, like he's jumping on, like, a heel. I think I feel that. Do you feel that? I kind of do. Like, he's kind of jumping on a heel, on a hillside, maybe a green one. To brighten it up, pop him up, maybe put the rainbow back there.
Oh, that's cute.
Okay, so let's do some green. Here's a piece of green, and I will cut it down. I mean, do you see how quickly you could do this? So quickly, like in a moment, in a second. All right, so here's what I'm gonna do. I'm just going to cut myself a hillside to start with. So I'm thinking something like maybe down and then up for him to be jumping off of. So something like that down here. Let's see how that looks with him. Oh, that's cute. That's so cute. Okay, like that. So then I'm going to trim this.
You always cut good ground.
That's funny. I always hate the way my...
I overthink ground.
I always don't like the way mine looks. Isn't that funny that you like it? And I'm always like, eh, don't love it. All right, so to make it match, I'm going to punch these corners so it matches the base down here. So that will live down there. See how quick? It's quick. It is quick. Lots of folks in the chat today. Narwhal. A narwhal is the unicorn of the sea. I like that. That's cute. Oh, I'm reading and not paying attention.
Stop reading.
Stop reading. Y'all, I'm very excited. Yesterday we filmed the interview with EK from Cards for Kids. I cannot wait for you guys to see that video. We learned so much about EK. So much about Cards for Kids, and there's such cool stuff coming. I just can't wait for y'all to meet him. That's the big thing. I've been telling him, I need my people to meet you. So you're going to get to. You guys. Where do I want it? Oh, so cute. It's so cute. I want him up there a little bit, maybe down lower over here with that over there. He's kind of looking at the rainbow, so maybe the rainbow over here. I'm committing. That one's down. This one I'm going to pop up. That's cute.
So cute.
All right, so let's pop that up. Foam me up, Scotty. Foam me up, Scotty. Let's see. One there. What does it say? I'd pull out my inner Brenda and tear. You should do that. You literally should do that. Tear. Brenda tears all the time. And I think that's a good thing to do. I think tearing is always a good option if you're comfortable with it. I have no issue with you not wanting to tear anything because I don't like to tear anything either. But I get it. Now, I'm thinking I'm probably going to ink the edges of this one just for the heck of it, just because I can. But I'm trying to think what color. Maybe blue, especially at the top. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and put him down. He'll be fine.
The Cricut Joy has an app you can download that you use.
The Joy app can be confusing because people think you can't use Design Space also, but you can. Cricut Design Space app, but they have a bonus Joy app that works just with the Joy and only works on iOS at this point. And that it's a bonus one. And I just think it's fantastic. Look, he's jumping off the ground. Okay, let's ink with leftover ink. Let's do that. Let's just ink with what I've got on here. I just want to bring it in a little. Bring it in.
She's so lucky she's getting a Maymay card.
You want to get a stamp to put on the inside? Like a birthday stamp? Maybe from Birthday Blessings or either from... If you want to put the number
Let
5 in here, we can put
our
that from how many?
Handy little stamp basket.
Yeah. If you want to put, like, happy 5th birthday or whatever, look, he's turning 5 is on how many? Y'all, I didn't even put any ink on there, but that worked. I didn't even dip it in. That's great. Keep it right handy and just go. And I think I'm going to white stitch line on the ground, at the top of the ground. I think right here it'll be cute. Just to accentuate that. Did y'all see Shannon just walk away? I said, go find a stamp. That's what she did.
Did
you find it?
I did. Look who's turning 5.
That'll be cute. So see, if you pre-made these, if you just sat down one day and had your stuff and just got to playing, you could have these made up in your stash, and then when it's time to do it, pick out the right stamp for the right person. And for Lucy, we know. Did you tell him who Lucy is?
Lucy is my niece. She's my sister's little girl. It's like my son Noah's sister, basically. They treat each other like brother and sister. They're both only childs. They're only childs.
They're very good friends.
They are bestest of
Although,
friends.
Although, no, Noah's my best friend. He won't admit it. Well, he's never going to admit it out loud.
He'll say Thomas is his best
He'll
friend.
He'll say Thomas is, but he will not admit that I am, but we all know. We all know. Because when Thomas isn't here, he doesn't run looking for Thomas. When he's not here, he doesn't run looking for him. When he's here, he runs looking for him. I'm going to go back over these lines. I got my pen working better toward the end. I want them a little wider, a little more poppy. Okay, then down here, oh, I should probably white stitch line up there too. Y'all love watching the paint dry this, right? So I'm going to do it. It needs it. At the bottom, I'm going to go back through my stickers and put some stickers down here for something cute. I don't know what, though. Now that we know we did it with the unicorn, we'll pick out something cute. That side. Now this side.
Oh, that's precious.
So you guys, I need y'all to come to the after show because I want to talk to you guys about something cool that's happening this weekend for Cards for Kids. I've already mentioned it in one video, and I know some of you guys made it to that, but I want you to come back and listen because I've got so much to tell you about, and I want to tell you about EK's video that goes up tomorrow. I want you guys to make sure you see it, so I want to give you some information about all that stuff. It's real important stuff that's happening at Cards for Kids, and it's something that everybody can get involved in, whether you have money or talent or not, like whether you make cards or not, whether you donate money or not, there's a place for you to get involved. So I want y'all to think about watching the after show today so I can tell you more. All right. Do you want ride with unicorns, chase rainbows? Do you want wish? Is there Make It in here? Let's just see. Best day ever. So sweet. Be yourself. My girl. Life is better. That's about dance. Hello, my name is. That's cute.
She does dance.
You are amazing. You are my happy place. Playtime. So sweet. Imagine. You make life so sweet. Cute as a cupcake. Pretty princess. Love your smile. All of that's appropriate. So love, so smart, sweetheart, little girl. How about, you don't want to say little girl. I was going to say happy birthday, little girl. Will she get offended by that?
Oh, no. She's a little girl.
She doesn't mind it?
No.
Happy birthday, little girl. Or happy birthday, the one we found in here earlier. Happy birthday. I found it earlier. Do you remember what it was? Beautiful. I don't see girl. I thought I found girl. Dun, 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 dun. Sweetheart. Sweetheart. Happy birthday, sweetheart. Yeah, that's what it was. Happy birthday, sweetheart. So let's get those out of there. I was like, it was something we found it. So I'm going to put happy birthday here.
I don't know if, let's see, Beth Salter wants to know if we'll be getting Tim Holtz's Kitsch Flamingo Distressing.
Probably.
I'll write it down on the list to remind him.
Vince usually orders the new stuff that they send him, like the new inks. We at least try it one time. You know, like if it's not popular, if it doesn't sell well, we probably won't bring it back. But if it does... I'm thinking about putting some flowers on here. Think about adding some flowers like this. Let's zhuzh it up. Let's zhuzh it. These are really cute in here. Some that go the other way. Oh, these do. Just a little added something. It might have been too much, but I think it's cute. Maybe we'll even do more. It might have been too much. Let's do more. Actually, I might like these other flowers better. Let's take these off. I'll put those back afterwards. I like the flower idea, but I got a different idea for the flowers. Let's try something different here. I like these little flowers. Yeah. Shannon got a real microphone. She's not using it today because Vinny's not here, but she got a real microphone. Now she can sit at her table and still be heard.
That's okay. Turn Shannon's mic off.
Yeah. Can somebody turn Shannon down? I doubt we're ever going to hear that, Shannon.
All right. Y'all hear me now?
Your mic died on you.
Yep.
All right. You know how we find out that they do? When we're using them.
When y'all tell
us. I don't want to waste batteries. I don't want to change batteries every time. You know, I should do like we do at church. At church, we have these rechargeable batteries, and like every Sunday, they just change out the battery. I should do that. All right, so.
Do you think we'll remember to change them out?
No.
Back on the charger to have them charge?
No. I think we do pretty good with them.
I am legit now.
You guys can hear her. Now I'm just drawing stems for my flowers.
Aww.
And I think I'm going to give them little leaves.
Miss Jones said, in honor of the unicorn, how about a cornflower?
Oh, did I have any in there?
I don't know.
I don't know flowers well enough.
I don't know. I don't either. Those are cute.
And then maybe some dots around them, because dots always look cute. You're probably thinking, but there's dots on the paper. Yeah, but that's a solid color dot, because yeah. That's green.
It's a solid paper.
Did they already talk about it? I'm sure. It's a solid.
It is a solid. Aww.
That's cute, y'all. She probably doesn't want my hair. She doesn't need my DNA. We'll get rid of that. So there's the front. That was just stickers. How fun was that?
Gracious.
Let's stamp the inside. Let's do some stamping. So I'm going to stamp in here. We'll put that on in a few minutes. We're going to use how many. So we're going to use look who's turning 5. And then I'll put, I don't need happy birthday because it's on the front. And then you can just sign it.
Yeah.
Unless you want inside. I don't care. It's your card.
I'll sign it.
Your card. So look who's turning 5. And I think I'm going to stamp directly on because I think it'll be cute. You don't have to. You could stamp onto a piece of cardstock and then mount it. Maybe I want to do that. Maybe I want to put some yellow in here to brighten up the inside. Since she's 5, she doesn't want bland. She wants bright.
Happy joy, joy.
I'm feeling her wanting bright.
She's a bright kid.
Let's do these. And what size is this? It's just big enough. And I think I will punch it also to match. So for those that struggle with stickers, I think the best advice is the more you play with stickers, the better you get. Because, and the other thing is, don't be afraid. Like, I've seen people think that every corner of the sticker has to be exposed, and that's not really true. You can layer them, stack them on top of each other, cut them off. Did you see what I did in the album where I cut it in half and trimmed it up? You don't have to let the whole sticker doesn't have to show. And if you look at people that use stickers for their design, and you'll see that sometimes they'll layer them on top of each other, or, I mean, who knows? Who knows? Just play. So look who's turning. Oh, I'm glad I did that on yellow, because that is cute.
Aw, that is cute.
That is cute. Let's do a number 5. Look who's turning 5. And then you have to say, it's you, you're turning 5.
Oh, Lucy Hazel.
Look, what I love about this set is, I think I did this one time, I can't remember, but like my in-laws, like, it'd be funny to do a card for her that says, look, he's turning 84. you can do it with this set, like, for anybody.
This year.
Look, what are you this year, though? That's, you're not a bad year.
40.
Is this 40? I was thinking it was 39.
This is, no, 39 was... 39 was the birthday that didn't get celebrated.
Listen, I definitely have to do Jared's big 3-0. Look, he's turning 30. Like, it's a kid card. I should totally do it like this, like a kid card. Look, he's turning 30.
What did you make the tree one say?
Happy birthday, handsome dude. Look, he's turning 30. That's Jared's card. I love it. That's funny. He'll think that's hilarious. He has that kind of sense of humor. I think I'd have to go through and make him one of the superhero because he's a big superhero fan. So if I did him one like a little kid card, you know, that'd be so funny.
It was pretty packed.
Was it?
Yeah. I didn't save it this time. Last time we made a video. I've
even filmed it, like doing it to show y'all how much is in it. Y'all, I just got ink on here because that's what I do. You won't know it. She won't know it. Just erase it. There we go. Look who's turning 5.
The number of the set is how many?
That set is called How Many. That would be so, I can't wait to do, look, he's turning 30. I gotta make you a 40th. I'll have to do something special. I'll have to do something special for her 40th. My son will be 40 in a couple weeks, Karen says.
That'll be in March.
They were telling me all of the birthday plans for Emmy and then what's coming up for Addie because their birthdays are coming up. And I said, well, what about the big 3-0? And Jared went, oh. Don't talk about it. I don't want to talk about it.
Just another day.
Not for his mama. It's a big deal for me. This card's cute.
That's precious.
It's real cute. I put that on there very crooked, but I bet Lucy's not going to notice. She's going to be like, how cute. And look who's turning.
It's all on how many. The look who's turning is on how many.
Let me take it out so I can see it.
Yeah.
So you get the numbers. You get an ampersand, a percent, and a number sign. You get S, T, R, D, T, H, and N, D. So this is like first, second, third, fourth, fifth, like that. Then look who's turning, and then there's happy birthday, and then there's a question mark, and then an exclamation. And this says, I am So you can go, I am 10 years here and then old down here. And then happy anniversary is added too. So this set's called How Many. Yep. See, I think it'd be funny, Debbie, like, look, he's turning 65.
My birthday is March 24th.
She is the day before Jared.
Day before Josh.
Josh. I did that. She's the day before Josh. I had Josh in my head and said Jared. Jared is, so it's Joe on the 8th, Jared on the 15th, Josh on the 25th, Shannon on the 24th right between there, and then Vince's dad is underneath there, and then Emmy's the 13th. I should have backed up.
Yeah.
8, 13, 15, 24, 25, and I think Granddad
March is
27.
March is a big month because I started here. I was hired on March 8th because I interviewed on my anniversary, which is our wedding anniversary is also the 8th.
I didn't realize you interviewed on your anniversary.
Yeah. But I started work on the 11th of March. Then our wedding anniversary is the 8th. Joe's birthday is the 8th. Then everybody else's birthday follows.
It all falls into sequence.
March is a good month.
The first month she was with us, she and Josh shared the birthday lunch. We used to. Y'all, there was a time.
We could go to restaurants.
We used to go to restaurants, and we would literally go out as a group and celebrate everybody's birthday. And in March, we went a lot. And in April, we went a lot. And in May, it was me. We didn't have a lot of Mays. Well, no, yes, we did, too, because we had Brenda and we had Amanda's March. Brenda's May. Mandy was May, wasn't she? Or was she April?
I can't remember.
In my family, from May to September is really not that many. So May usually ends us up. Look, that's two cards. We've been doing this for 35 minutes, chatting, having a good time. And they're really not hard to do, are they? They're super easy. And another thing you can do is come in here and, like, if you have little bird stamps or anything, like, you can totally zhuzh this up. Maybe you have some cloud stamps. You can mix them together. And I think it's super cute.
Oh, it's March babies.
Mm-hmm. So these are in my opinion, these are the kinds of things you should keep in your stash. Especially if you hate to fussy cut.
Yeah.
If fussy cutting's not your thing, keep these kinds of things in your stash and it puts a card together super fast. Also, something that I think every card maker should keep in their stash is card bases and envelopes, pre-made. So I get asked all the time, can you teach us how to make your envelopes? Yes, here's how I do it. Here's why. I have never found a paper that I like to make envelopes with. I don't like using scrapbook paper because I don't think it lands well. I don't think it folds well, all that kind of stuff. I don't want to use cardstock because it adds bulk. And then I'm like, these are perfect. And envelope sets are cheap. We have them in the store in all different sizes because we have them in A2 and also 5x7. We have just envelope kits. We have white kits like this. And it's just so much easier just to pull your envelope out. I have an envelope punch board. I actually have two envelope punch boards. And I love them. I use them for things besides envelopes. But I just have never found a better option than just buying them pre-made. You can buy them from all over the place, and I like them. So that's my answer for what do I do for how do I make my envelopes. There you go, guys. There you go. Oh, they want me to put bling on the flowers. You want bling on the flowers? Is she too young for bling? She's five.
She's five.
She won't peel it off and eat it.
No. Although I never thought I would walk in and see my 8-year-old cutting his stray hairs that are sticking up. So, you know.
You need to tell them that. That's funny.
Yesterday morning, I was getting ready. I told Noah to go to our bathroom and brush his hair. And I walked back into him getting my hair cutting scissors and clicking them back in. Their little holder thing and putting them down. And I'm like, Noah, what you doing? And he's like, just cutting my hair. And I was like, what hair did you cut? And when he wakes up, he has the bed head and it sticks up right at his crown. And he's like, these wouldn't quite lay down, so I just chopped them off.
So, I have not been influencing him.
No.
I've had nothing to do with that.
He's never tried to cut his hair before, and I don't know if it's just because they were laying there on the counter. But, yeah.
It's probably because you've been cutting his hair and he's more.
Yeah, well,
it's
Sunday,
like we do this
Sunday
at home.
Sunday I did around his ears and his neck because our hair girl's enjoying the snow in the mountains. Yeah, it snowed in Gatlinburg. And she sent me pictures.
Oh, great. It's
beautiful. But, yeah, so.
All right, I added bling.
Bling it.
It is cute. Bling it on. All right, there's Lucy's card.
Aw, thanks.
So, we're going to head into the after show, and if you guys don't mind, come over there so we can chat about whatever we want to chat about. We did our cards. We did them quick. I love doing quick cards like that. So Let's head. You ready? You got the link?
I don't know if Tamitha's put it in yet, but I'm
Shannon's going to link, or either Tamitha's going to link the after show in the chat, so you'll have it real quick. I'm not putting a sun on it. It's good, y'all. Look, let's just, she's like, okay, everyone, all at once, say sun. Don't do it. We're fixing to go off. We're good. We're good. If you want to put a sun on yours, put a sun on yours. That's the beauty of it. So let's don't spam the chat. There they go. Too late. All right, there is the after show. And the reason I ask you not to spam the chat like that is because when we're trying to get the links to folks, if you start throwing in all those words, it kind of moves the chat out of the way and people can't get to the links. That's the only reason. So, all right. So there's the link for the after show, and we're going to end the-